Yeah? I want to make a quick note here. This photo was taken in 1977 when I was 17. Now, last month, the Jewish calendar switched over to 5777. Excuse me, it's bouncing around a little bit. Well, we all know wow, that was weird. Just had somebody in a FedEx truck taking my photo. I don't know why they did that. But anyhow, we all know that I took this in 77 when I was 17. Now, if you add 40 years to that, this is now from the 70s. To 2016, that's like 50, you know, that's the 5 year mark. If you add 4 plus 10, that's 5. Then it's 77 at 17, that would be 5777. Ain't that something? How things work here? We have arrived, my friends. That dream I had last night, it was telling me it's over, it's time. You know, I see it where I was able to fly, and nothing's gonna get in there. The Father of Heaven, man, the Holy Spirit, Jesus Christ, they're all huge, they're huge. They can do what they wanna do. And the, I don't care if they're eternal fallen angels, man, they're limited to what they can do. Any power that anybody has, it comes from the Father in heaven. That's why I say only through him, you know. Lucifer's power was through God. That's why he was the most powerful angel in heaven. Well, he's not anymore. You know, now Michael, the archangel, you know. That's what I'm saying. God's in control of everything. That commercial where I showed you on that last video, that store called Target. Remember now, we're dealing with demonic principalities. Now, what you see, you have to think in the spiritual realm, not in the worldly, because that's what they do. They're all about the spiritual realm. That's the reason why things are starting to be revealed now. And we're seeing it. Those of us that have been separated anyhow, not everybody else. You know, once you get separated, you'll see exactly what's getting ready to happen. But every day, somebody just told me how they just said, gave thanks to the Lord already this morning and everything. You know, every day, every night, all day, that's all I think about. You know, you could say that I'm consumed. See, here's my affliction. All my shirts say affliction. Those are the ones the Lord's coming for. You know, he's coming for those that love those, that were there for those in these times, you know. But a lot of people ain't going to see this getting ready to happen here. Yeah, but we can't help them. I know a lot of us did try to talk and warn to people, but, you know, that's what we did these past several years. Now our time's up. Now we can go home. We can have rest. And once we get into our eternal bodies, all these attacks that we've been experiencing, it's going to be over. We're going to have peace, love, no more attacks, no more evil, you know. It's going to be nice. Going to be beautiful. And the Lord can cleanse and remove everything that this ever was. Whatever this ever was to anybody, he can cleanse us of it. And just be ready. I can tell by the attacks that I'm getting on the channels, other people are getting them. We're so very close now. It's like unbelievable how close we are. And it's really going to happen here soon. My dreams have been showing that to me. I'm ready. I'm tired. Count it as a blessing, your affliction. When you're being attacked, you have to rebuke it, you fight it, but count it. When you just know it as a blessing, because they're only attacking those that they don't have. So you need to remember. Remember this. And count it as a blessing. Okay, yes, you might be tired and wore out, but it would be better to be overcoming this, being attacked, learning, because you have power too now. You can learn to become stronger. Don't give in to them. Start seeking and finding out the strength that you actually have. Once you start doing that, the attacks become less, or they'll switch over to something else, you know? But these things, whether they're sexual or whether they're battles, fighting crocodiles, who knows what, man. They come at you all kinds of ways. We have to overcome them. Don't take no pleasure in them. And I constantly, you know, even if I think of something I did when I was 10 years old, I'm constantly like, wow, Lord, forgive me, you know. I mean, there's things I can't even remember that I probably did. Forgive me for all that. You know? And, he does. We're about to leave this place. All this is all, artificial. That's why, you notice how they're selling gold on, the stock market and stuff? And, saying how money's becoming worthless? Well, the Bible, it says, Jesus says, I encourage you to buy gold and silver from me, not here, okay? Because there's nothing here that's going to last, and nobody's taking nothing with them, no matter what they got. That's the reason why a lot of these words are in the Bible, so you'll understand them according to the times we're in today. I seen in the newspaper walking out something about the stock market's up higher than it's ever been. Because Trump's in there. You know, people feel big. Well, let me tell you something. That's the devil. They're just wanting to get people's minds back into the world before this comes up, which is coming up now. We who are separated and awake, we're aware of this. But those that are still asleep, we can't prevent them from staying asleep. You know, it's just the way it is. You know, they're going to be thinking, wow, you know, things are getting better. No, they're not. You know, they're not. They're putting their faith and hope and trust in another man. He is the last Trump. The last. But anyhow, guys, God bless each and every one of you. And be ready. Look up. Because it's going to happen when you least expect it. We don't have to be in fear of nothing.
If they can stop me, I'm not gonna change my mind. No one can keep me from the road that I'm on this time. No matter what, I'm gonna do what it takes to make it. Yeah.
I know this is the one.